This video highlights new and existing view options for alignment tracks in the GDV and CBI's Genome Data Viewer. We'll focus on BAM alignment data that are hosted remotely and how to view haplotype structural variation, but many of the display options you'll see also apply to viewing other types of data, such as blast results and SRA data. I'll start on the GDV homepage, and for this demo, change to the GRCH37 assembly and click Browse Genome. To load the remote BAM file, use the User Data and Track Hubs menu. I'll first point out the supported file and data types, and notice that for remote BAM and VCF files, the directory you point to must contain the corresponding index files. Okay, I'll select Options, Add Remote Files, and paste in the URL for my file. And I'll give the new track a name, Trio, and click Add. You see a warning, but the data were added successfully. Warnings like these report incongruities between the file and the genome assembly. For instance, that the file contains extra sequences that are not in the assembly. Details has more specific information. Your added tracks are placed at the bottom, but you can move any track by click and drag in the track's title bar. I'm going to clean up a bit by using the red X on the right to delete some tracks. And you might also notice that the added track is shaded green. This differentiates user-added tracks from those provided by NCBI. At this zoom level, we're seeing all of chromosome 1, and the coverage graph of reads in our Trio track appears to show good even coverage across the chromosome. This big gap is the centromere region. Let's zoom in a bit and display a specific 100 kilobase region by typing in the search widget on the left. I want to go to chromosome 1, 69,900K to 70,000K. We're getting more detail at this level, where red denotes areas with more mismatches and black denotes indel variation in the read coverage. In the region 69,940K to 69,945K, notice the dips, suggesting deletions relative to the genome reference. I'll zoom to this region, and we see two regions where most of the reads have these deletions or gaps. I'll spend the next couple minutes adjusting various track settings to explore some of the display options available. You can use the gear icon next to the delete icon in the track title, or the one in the tooltip. I'll click on the one in the tooltip and change a few settings. I'll check the box for Show Pileup, keeping the pileup display set to Match Mismatch Graph Count, and in the Hide Alignments menu, I'll choose to hide both duplicates and bad reads. In the Sort Alignments by menu, I'll choose Haplotype, then hit Apply. The pileup graph is just below the track title, and in this Match Mismatch Graph Count display, clearly marks the two indel regions. The reads are now clustered by haplotype, haplotype 1, haplotype 2, and haplotype not set. Notice that haplotype 2 does not have the deletions seen in haplotype 1. Let's use highlight and zoom to sequence around the smaller indel region on the left side. At this level, all the mismatches, deletions, the dark red lines, and insertions, the blue bars, are apparent. The length of an insertion correlates to size of the blue bar. Okay, let's look at one of the other pileup display options. I'll go back into track settings and change pileup display to match mismatch table count, but you see that other options are available. I'll hit apply, and the pileup table now indicates the individual read counts for a match, mismatch, gap, or intron. Refer to the legend on the left. Also, higher counts are shaded more darkly. You see this easily in the gap region. Now let's take a look at a reads tooltip. There's a lot of good information there. A mouse over on a reads row activates the tooltip, and I'll click this push pin to keep it open. So here we can get orientation, the span of that read on the reference molecule, percent coverage, and so on. You also get a cigar string, and at the bottom you have a button called View to see any unaligned regions. Here the unaligned reads are in red, and you can copy-paste this sequence for further analysis, for example to see if this is vector sequence or part of a translocation or chimera. Be aware that this tooltip information is also present for other types of alignment data, such as BAM files for expression data or for BLAST data. The last example is a quick look for NCBI ref SNPs in the region of structural variation we've seen here. I want to add a track of those ref SNPs, so I'll go to the Tracks menu, Configure Tracks, and show the variation tracks we can choose from. Let's go to the most recent DB SNP build, 153, and select Live Ref SNPs. I'll then hit Configure. Here is the added ref SNPs track, and there is a ref SNP in this region, the RS ending in 8066. In the tooltip for the RS, you get a link to the SNP record where you can investigate this further. That's all for this video. We'd love to have your questions and feedback, so please use either the feedback form in the Help menu or the Support Center link near the bottom of most NCBI web pages.